And as we do the coin toss, captains for Johnson High School, Malik Brown, Isaiah Scott, and Deshaun Mitchell. Captains for Windsor Forest, Isaiah Cooper, Zach Patterson, Marquise Lunnan, and Tracon Johnson. Windsor Forest won a toss and will elect to receive. The GHSA and its member schools have made a commitment to promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators at all GHSA sanctioned events. Profanity, degrading remarks, and intimidating actions directed at officials, competitors, or other spectators will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the event site. Spectators are not allowed to enter the competition area prior to, during, or after the conclusion of the contest. Violators are subject to removal from the venue. Thank you for your cooperation and promotion of good sportsmanship at today's event. And here come the Knights. And here come the Atom Smashers. As you can see, we do have a scoreboard malfunction. I'll do my best to keep up with the time for you guys, score. Other than that, Friday Night Lights here in Savannah, the Coastal Empire. Kicking off for the Adams Smashers, number 22, Brendan Collins. Back deep for the Knights, Marquise Lunnan, number 11. Kickoff received by number 6, Jason Jackson. I believe number 25, Nathaniel Thompson on the tackle. Ball's gonna be placed at about the 20, let's call it the 27 yard line, first down and 10. Hand up the middle for a short loss. Run by number 5, Cameron Woods. Talk about number 8, Isaiah Scott. Bring up second down. Second down at about 12. Keeper by quarterback Isaiah Cooper. Wrestled down by number 2, Jaden Polite. Gonna bring up third down. Let's call it 3rd and 19. Ball's about the 18 yard line. And a fumble on the play. Recovered by the Knights. Gonna bring up a 4th down. Ball's on about the 12 yard line. It's called about 4th and 25. Punt by number 8, Isaiah Cooper. Returned by Trayshawn Robinson. Tackle by 72, Courtney Patrick. Punt's gonna be run down to about the 16-yard line for the Knights. The Adams Smashers take over first down and 10. Middle by number 5, Malik Brown. Talk about 72, Courtney Patrick. Gain of about 3 on the play. We'll bring up 2nd down and 7. Quarterback keeper for about 2 yards. I'll bring up 3rd and 5. Tackle by a host of Knights. Run by number 5, Malik Brown. Once again, kicking off for the Adams Special, number 22, Brandon Collins. Back deep for the Knights, number 11, Marquise Lennon. Kickoff again received by number 6, Jason Jackson. Tackle by number 10, Damian Smith, and a host of other Adam Smashers. Ball's gonna be brought out to the 34-yard line of the Knights. They'll take over first down and 10. And we have a run by Isaiah Cooper. Tackle by number 8, Isaiah Scott. Had a fumble on the play. And I believe that fumble was recovered by number 3, Anthony Lavalis. And with the turnover, that's gonna bring up third and goal from about the 27. And we have a timeout in Windsor Forest. Let's call it second down and 9, 1 yard gain on the play. Thank you. starts at the timeout. Just want to remind everyone, the score is 7-0. We're still in the first quarter, fourth down and 10, Knights. Back deep to punt, number 8, Isaiah Cooper. Back deep to receive, Jaden Pugh and Trishawn Robinson. So with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left here in the first quarter, punt was received by number 11, Jaden Pugh. Ran it down to about the 38-yard line of the Knights. And they'll take over, the Smashers will take over first down and 10 from the Knight 38-yard line. 3 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first quarter. By number 15, Malachi Bacon. Gain of about 3 on the play. Gonna bring up second down and 7. Keeper by number 15, Malachi Bacon. Tackle by number 8, Isaiah Cooper. Gonna bring up third down and 7. And the third down play is going to lead to a sack. Sack by number 21, Jameer Axon. Cleaned up by number 72. I'm sorry, 21, Jameer Axon. Cleaned up by number 72, Courtney Patrick. Coming up fourth down for the Smashers. First flag of the game. Come back up the Smashers 5 yards. Still fourth down. And a punt's going to sail out of bounds. However, we do have a flag on the play. Oh, yeah. We actually had two flags on the play. A holding against the Smashers, roughing the kicker against the Knights. Those penalties are offset. Replay fourth down. And we have another penalty going to be assessed against the Smasher. And punt was actually fielded by number 50. Although we do have a flag and a little skirmish on the field. Referees are sorted out. We have all set and penalty on the field. It's gonna be first down Knights. And ladies and gentlemen, we've reached the end of the first quarter here in our stadium. The Johnson Smashers 7, the Windsor Forest Knights 0. And as we begin the second quarter, it'll be first down and 10 Knights, ball's on the 34-yard line. Run by number 5, Cameron Woods, brought down by number 8, Isaiah Scott. Loss of about 2 on the play, gonna bring up second down and 12. And we have an obvious flag on the play. Offsides against the Smashers. Advance the ball 5 yards for the Knights. Bring up second down and 7. Ball's on the 37. And a pass complete. Touchdown, Knights. And the extra point attempt is good. So here at Savannah High Stadium, we have a new score. Johnson Adams Special 7, your Windsor Forest Knights 7. Kicking off for the Knights, number 51, Justin Hicks. Kickoff fielded by number 3, Anthony Lavalis. Brought down at about the 22-yard line. Be first down and 10, Smashers. Run by number 8, Isaiah Scott. Talk about number 50, Kendall Carter. Short loss on the play. Gonna bring up second down and 11. Run by number 8, Isaiah Scott. Positive gain on the play. It's called about third down and 6 at the gain of about 5. So the third down play is going to result in a loss for the Smashers. Going to bring up fourth down. 8 minutes, 50 seconds left here in the second quarter. Your score is 7-7. About a fourth down and 8 for the Smashers coming up. Ball's on about the 24-yard line. Thank you. punt by number 22, Brendan Collins, going to be down at about the 44-yard line of the Knights. They'll take over, first down and 10. And we have 8 minutes, 5 seconds left here in the second quarter. 8 minutes, 5 seconds, ladies and gentlemen, till halftime. 8 minutes, 5 seconds. Your score, 7-7. Run by number 5, Cameron Woods, back to the line of scrimmage, gonna bring up second down and 10. And the third down pass play is going to be complete. Pass complete to number 11, Marquise London. It's going to be good enough for a night first down. Ball's going to be placed at the 34-yard lines of Adder Smashers. First down and 10 Knights. Huge loss on the play. Run by number 8, Isaiah Cooper. About 6 minutes and 30 seconds left here. Second down play is going to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up third down. Probably about third and 18. Referee indicates offsides against the Smashers. Gonna advance the ball 5 yards for the Knights. So let's call it third and 13. Ball's on about the 38-yard line. And the third down pass play is going to fall incomplete. Going to bring up fourth down for the Knights. So on fourth and 13, looks like the Knights going to punt. Punt fielded by number 1, Trayshawn Robinson. Tackle, I believe, by number 13, Calvin Garcia. Let's give that young man a hand. Godspeed, positive vibes, positive energy for a speedy recovery. And as we resume action, it'll be third down and 10 with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left here in the second quarter. Your score is 7-7. And then a heavy rush, number 15. Malachi Bacon's gonna be brought down. Gonna bring up fourth down and 10 for the Smashers. Looks like they're gonna elect a punt. And we have a timeout on the field. Timeout's gonna be assessed to the Smashers. And with halftime quickly approaching, the score is still 7-7. Punt's gonna go out of bounds about the 47-yard line. 2 minutes left to halftime. Be first down and 10 for the Knights. Ball's at the 47-yard line. 2 minutes. So as we resume action, 2 minutes to halftime, first down and 10 Knights, ball on the home 47-yard line. And no gain on the play. Run by number 8, Isaiah Cooper, gonna bring up second down and 10. Minute 35 left the halftime. Minute 35. And we have a referee's gonna call it an incomplete pass. Third down and 10. Minute and 6 seconds left of halftime. Minute and 6 seconds left here in the second quarter. And we have a timeout on the field. Timeout's gonna be assessed to Windsor Forest. So with 1 minute and 6 seconds left to halftime, 1 minute and 6 seconds left here in the second quarter, your score is still Windsor Forest 7, Johnson Adams Smashers 7. So as we resume second quarter action, minute 6 seconds left to halftime, be third down and 10, Knights. And we have a loss on the play. Tackle by number 53, Nashawn Mitchell. Gonna bring up fourth down. Timeout on the field. Timeout, says to the Smashers. Ladies and gentlemen, we have 46 seconds left to halftime. 46 seconds. And the punt's gonna be fielded by number 11, Jaden Pugh. Run down by number 11 and number 8, Marquise London and Isaiah Cooper. So 27 seconds left to halftime. Be first down and 10, Smashers. Ball on their own 43-yard line. 27 seconds left to halftime, ladies and gentlemen. And the first down pass play is going to be incomplete. Pass intended for number 11, Jaden Pugh. So second down and 10, 23 seconds left, 23 seconds left, second down and 10. And the second down pass play is gonna be tipped, gonna fall incomplete. Gonna bring up third down and 10. So we have 15 seconds left to halftime. 15 seconds left here in the second quarter. Be third down and 10, Smashers. Ball on their own 42-yard line. And the third down pass play is going to fall incomplete. So the play is going to be a fourth down. An official timeout on the field. We have 7 seconds left at halftime. 7 seconds, ladies and gentlemen, at halftime. Looks like those young men are okay. Let's give them a hand. And we have a timeout on the field. Timeout's gonna be assessed to Windsor Forest. So as we resume action here in the second quarter, there's 7 seconds left, fourth down and 10 smashers. And the pass is going to be complete to number 11, Jaden Pugh. That'll be the final play of the half as we enter our halftime score in a tightly contested match between Johnson and Windsor Forest. Your score, 7-7.
Go back to the band after this. All right. Brasil mesmo.
Else right now.
And ladies and gentlemen, we have about 4 minutes. 4 minutes left to the third quarter. So ladies and gentlemen, we'll be kicking off in approximately 3 minutes. 3 minutes to kick off the second half. Here in Savannah High Stadium, we have a score of 7-7. If I'm not mistaken, Johnson will receive the second half kickoff.
Johnson.
As we begin our second half, kicking off for the Knights, number 51, Justin Hicks. And that kickoff's gonna sail out of bounds. Bring out a flag on the play. And they'll re-kick the kickoff. They back him up 5 yards. Justin Hicks will retry the kick. Try to get this third quarter started. Lead kickoff was fielded by number 4, Darion Johnson. Wrestled down by number 11, Marquise Lennon. Smash is going to take over, first down and 10. Ball is going to be at their own 27-yard line. And number 8, Isaiah Scott, busts loose for a big gain for the Smashers. Out to about the 46-yard line, gain of the play, going to be enough for a first down. Another run by Isaiah Scott. Short gain on this play. Gain of about 1. Gonna bring up 2nd down and 9. Another short run by Isaiah Scott, gave him about 1 yard, and we got 3rd down and 8. Tackle by a host of Knights. Thank you. Third down pass play is going to be incomplete. Bring up fourth down for the Smasher. Is going to be complete. Real close to a first down. Let's see what the officials say. And it looks like they may have been short. Looks like it's going to be first down and 10. Knights. Ball's on about the 44-yard line. Flag on the play. Confusion. Called false start on the play, but they moved the ball up 5 yards. So I guess that was actually offsides against the Smasher. And now the result of a play. It'll be a loss on first down, about 2. Gonna bring up second down and 7. And a short gain on the play, probably back to the original line of scrimmage. Going to be third down and 5 for the Knights. And we have about 8 minutes left here in the third quarter. 8 minutes left in the third quarter. Your score is 7-7, third and 5 for the Knights. Yeah. And we have a touchdown, Knights. However, there is a flag on the play. There is a flag on the play. We have holding. Holding's gonna be called against the Knights, gonna nullify that touchdown. Holding call's gonna be nullifying that touchdown. Fine run by number 8. All for naught. And a third down scramble. Gain of about 7 on the play, gonna bring up 4th down and 8. And the punt's gonna be fielded by number 24, Deshaun Lovett. Gonna be 1st down and 10. Adam smashes ball on their own 31-yard line. And we have 5 minutes and 20 seconds left here in the third quarter. 5 minutes, 20 seconds left here in the third quarter. With your score, Johnson High School 7, Windsor Forest High School 7. And we have a 1st down run, gain of about no gain on the play, actually gonna bring up 2nd down. Just wanna inform everyone that the scoreboard clock time is not working. However, we will keep the score on the scoreboard, but the time will actually be kept on the field. So you'll be able to see the score 7-7, but the time will be left on the field. So as we resume action, there's 4 minutes, 55 seconds left here in the third quarter. It'll be second down and 10, Johnson. Third down run is going to come up with a short loss. I'm going to bring up third down, I'm sorry. Timeout on the field. This other play is going to be a first down. Ball is going to be placed at about the 44-yard line. First down and 10, smashing. And we have a timeout on the field. Timeout's going to be assessed to the Johnson Adams Smashers. And that timeout's going to be at a 2 minute and 32 second mark here in the third quarter. And you can see your score, 7-7. As we resume action, 2 minutes, 32 seconds left in the third quarter. It'll be first down and 10. Smashers ball on their own 44-yard line. And the option play, option number 11, Jaden Pugh is going to be good enough for a smasher first down. Ball's going to be placed on about the 36-yard line of the Knights. First down and 10, smasher. Yeah. And the first down pass play is going to be incomplete. Make up second down and 10. Nice physical run by number 8. Isaiah Scott, gained about 5 on the play. Let's call it 6, 3rd down and 4. Down to about the 20-yard line. Game's gonna be good enough for another smasher first down. First down and 10, ball's on about the 20. First down play is going to result in a gain of about 1. Going to bring up second down and 9. Third quarter. So without score still, Johnson Adams Smasher 7. The Windsor Forest Knights 7. And as we resume action here in the fourth quarter, it's going to be second down and 9. Smashers, ball on about the 19-yard line.
Score!
And a short gain up the middle is going to bring up third down. Gain of about two on the play. It's called a third and seven. And a third down play is going to result in a sack. Sack's going to be by number 52, Marquis Eason. Huge loss on the play. Timeout on the field. So as we take this injury timeout, 10 minutes and 46 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Give that young man a hand. And the fourth down play is going to result in a huge loss. Have a turnover on down. It's going to be first down and 10 Knights. Ball's going to be at about the 43-yard line. First down run by number 8, Isaiah Cooper. Tackle by number 8, Isaiah Scott. No gain on the play, bring up second down. Huge loss on the play. Back to the 30-yard line. Loss of about 13 on the play. Gonna bring up about a third and 23. Had a third down pass, pass being incomplete. However, we do have a flag on the play. And the referee indicates pass interference against the defense. Replay third down. Coming up about third and eight. And we have another flag on the play. Referee indicates offside going against the smasher. Gonna bring up about a third down and three. And the third down play is going to be good enough for a Windsor Knight first down. Roughly 8 minutes left here in the third quarter, a little over 8 minutes left in the third quarter. Ball's going to be about the 42-yard line, first down and 10 Knights. Fumble on the play, recovered by the Knights. And let me correct myself, we are in the fourth quarter. And the third down, and the second down pass play is going to be complete. Got a flag at the end of the play. Had a fumble on the play. Gonna bring up fourth down. And fourth and goal from about the 6 yard line. About 6 minutes left in the game. 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Fourth down and goal, 6 yard line. And we have a timeout on the field, Knights. We have 5 minutes and 45 seconds left here in the ball game. 5 minutes, 45 seconds left. With the Knights knocking on the door. And it's going to be incomplete. Turnover on down. First down, Smashers. Up the turnover on downs will be first down and 10. Smashers balling on them about 6 yard line. Run to about the 13-yard line. Let's call it second down and 7. Got 5 minutes, 12 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. 5-12. And the second down run is going to result in a loss. Tackle by number 21, Jameer Axon. Coming up about a third down and 6 for the Smashers. And we have 4 minutes, 20 seconds here in the fourth quarter. 4 minutes and 20 seconds. And a short gain on the third down play, gonna bring up fourth down. It looks like the Smash is gonna elect the punt. 3 minutes and 25 seconds left here in the ball game. Tightly contested, 7-7. Fourth down and 4. And we have a timeout on the field. Timeout's going to be assessed to Johnson. That timeout's going to be taken with 3 minutes left here in the ball game. 3 minutes left in the ball game. So we resume action. 3 minutes left here in the ball game. Fourth and 4. Punt's gonna be fielded by number 5, Cameron Wood. Brought down at about the 38-yard line. Be first down and 10, Knights. Official timeout. First down run. By number 8, Isaiah Cooper. So with 2 minutes and 34 seconds left here in the ball game, gonna be first down and goal, Knights. Looks like the ball is on about the 9-yard line. Short gain on the play, gonna bring up second down and goal. Two minutes and 15 seconds left here in the ball game. Second down and goal for the Knights. Ball on about the 8-yard line. No signal yet. Looks like it's gonna be third and goal, ball on the 1/2-yard line. One minute, 30 seconds left here in the ball game. Third and goal on the 1/2-yard line for the Knights. Timeout on the field. Timeout's gonna be assessed by the Knights.
So when we resume action, there'll be 51 seconds left here in the ball game. 51 seconds left here in the ball game. Be third down and goal. Knights on the half yard line. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, third and goal, ball on the half yard line. And we have a loss on the play. Timeout on the field. Fourth down here in Savannah High Stadium. 40 seconds left here in the ball game. Big play coming up. Big play. So with 40 seconds left here in the fourth quarter, looks like the Knights are going to line up for a field goal. And the field goal is good. So we have a new score. It's Windsor Forest 10, Johnson High 7. Have a timeout on the field. So with 33 seconds left here in the game, 33 seconds left here in the game, Justin Hicks to kick off deep. I believe Trishawn Robinson and Jaden Pugh are back deep for Johnson. Thank you. And the kickoff taken by number 11. Jaden Pugh out to the 29-yard line. He first down and 10 smasher. Seconds left here in the ball game. First down and 10, Johnson. And the pass is going to be complete. However, the ball's down at the 34-yard line. Gain of about 5 on the play. They'll clock the ball. I'll bring up third down. So we have 3 seconds left here in the ball game. Be third down and 5 for the Smashers. Final play of the ball game. With their final score, Windsor Forest Knights 10, the Johnson Adams Smashers 7. I want to thank both teams for a great game. Everyone, please drive safe and have a good holiday weekend.